want to go back to the phone calls. Next up is Daniel listening in Chicago, Illinois. And hi, Daniel.
Hank, first and foremost, I want to thank you for your ministry. I've read several of your books. I'm presently engaged in a master's program in Christian apologetics at Biola University.
Oh, wonderful.
My question is not a technicality, but it's something that is interesting to me. And that is the concept of when a Christian dies and he's present with the Lord, you know, before Jesus comes again. So, you know, we're waiting for the second coming of Christ. And now a Christian dies, he believes in Jesus Christ, he's present with the Lord. Is that person, is that being outside of time and space continuum?
Well, I think what we want to say about this is that we have a completely different set of principles here that define that particular context, in that when you are non-physical, you don't even have locational qualities. So to ask where a soul is would be a category mistake. And I think this question falls into somewhat the same category. I think the best that we can say is, absent the body, we are present with the Lord. And that is a relational statement, not a locational statement, and only once again becomes a locational statement when the soul returns to the body and that body is resurrected, immortal, imperishable, incorruptible.
Okay, now that leads me to a second question, and I'm not trying to put you on the spot, Hank. I'm just trying to understand.
Sure.
If it's not a locational issue or a non-locational issue, like because you're not don't have a physical body, then in terms of, you know, everlasting or eternal presence with God versus eternal damnation, when you're eternally apart from the Lord, doesn't the eternal segment of that suggest some sort of time continuum?
Well, yeah, I think it does. But I also think that there's a very substantive difference between a transitional heaven and an eternal heaven. So if you were to die now, you'd be absent the body, present with the Lord. But that's a temporary state. That state changes when Jesus appears a second time, and then your soul returns to your body, and now you live in paradise restored. So in one sense, we can talk about the transitional heaven as being a person as opposed to a place, whereas the eternal heaven is both a person and a place.
And then in that eternal person and place, is there a concept of time?
Yeah, I think so. Now, time is a very, very difficult subject to grapple with, to get your hands around. But yeah, I think that we can say that there will be time in the new heaven and the new earth in the eternal state, very much like we experience time now. I've actually written about this in my book, which is titled Afterlife.
You know, I picked it up through Amazon, and it's going to come up. So I'm looking very much forward to reading.
Well, it's one of the questions that I deal with in the book.
Well, God bless you, Hank. Thank you very, very much. You're always very enlightened.
Well, thank you for your call, and thank you for your encouragement as well.